Stuff. Let's head to Dallas, where the Cowboys are currently 2-5, and there doesn't seem to be a light at the end of the tunnel. Andy Dalton is in concussion protocol, and Dallas's defense is on pace to give up the most points in NFL history. Hall of Famer Michael Irvin, my dog, called out his former team saying, quote, "The Cowboys right now may be the worst team in the NFL." He said this despite the Jets being the only winless team. So, Acho, is it crazy for Michael Irvin to say this?
My dog, I'll say yes, but here is my real answer, Sal. I think about this. I'm a reader, right? I have a book coming out, but I'm also a reader. There's a book by Malcolm Gladwell called Outliers.
Love it.
And in Malcolm Gladwell's Outliers, he simply says, America, that in height, basketball does matter to a point. Right? It's better to be 6'2 than 6'1 and 6'3 than 6'2 and 6'4 than 6'3 and so on. But many argue that Michael Jordan, the greatest of all time, he was 6'6. So there comes a point in time, Marcellus, where it doesn't matter how tall you are because you're tall enough.
Say it.
There's come the point in time with the Dallas Cowboys where it don't matter how sorry they are because they're sorry enough. Like, Marcellus, so they're sorry enough to be mentioned in the conversation
for really?
Worst team in the NFL.
Okay. And
so if Michael Irvin, the great Michael Irvin, Hall of Fame Michael Irvin,
Hall of Fame.
Cowboys Circle Ring of Honor Michael Irvin.
We know
Irvin.
Who he is.
If Big Dog Michael Irvin has the boldness, the audacity to come out here and say that they're the worst team in the NFL, who am I to argue with him? Who am I going to sit up here to defend the Dallas Cowboys against being the worst team in the NFL? Are they the worst? No, I don't think so. I think they beat the Jets if they both lined up on the field at the same time. I think. Am I sure? Absolutely not. Would I bet on it? Absolutely not. But what I can conclude, beyond the shadow of a doubt, like Michael Jordan was tall enough to be one of the greatest of all time, if not the greatest of all time, the Dallas Cowboys are currently sorry enough to be the worst of all time in this season.
Look, I could argue against Michael Irvin. I'm not arguing who plays receiver better. I know what his greatness and genius is, but if we're talking about our perception of something, how qualified as he is to talk about this, despite him being a much greater Dallas Cowboy than me. Maybe he's so far in the forest he can't see the trees, because I can. I only had 1 year in Dallas, and we know how that went. Acho, they're not even the worst team in their damn division. How in the hell are they the worst team in the NFL? You remember they beat the New York Football Giants. And let's also talk about, they also beat a one-win team called the Atlanta Falcons. If you really want to be real about this situation, the Cowboys actually only
lost... No. Don't say nothing reckless. I can hear some recklessness about to come out your mouth. Before you even did it, I had to cut you off because you're about to make my head hurt, my heart hurt. You're about to make everything hurt. I can feel it, Marcellus.
We have good chemistry because it's coming. It's coming. BS. But I'm about to drop this BS bomb on you, but it's real. The Cowboys have only lost to one bad team. Crazy as that sounds. Washington. Other than that, the loss to Seattle. How many losses do they have on the season? One. They lost to the Rams. How many losses they have on the season? Two. They lost to the Cardinals. How many losses they have on the season? Two. How many about the Browns? How many losses they have on the season? Two. Wait a minute. The Dallas Cowboys are closer than we think. And let's just be real. They are not in the Malcolm Gladwell bottom cellar of the league. You know why? There are seven teams with a worse record than the Dallas Cowboys. Jets, Giants, Falcons, Jaguars, Texans, Vikings, and Bengals. You're not even worse than your division. And there are seven teams worse than you by record. And let's just say if they had to line them up, the Cowboys might beat some of the teams with even a better record than them.
Marcellus, you were one of the best defense attorneys I've ever heard.
Dog, that's my calling.
You're one of the best.
And DJing.
I would make a correlation between you and the other better defense attorney, but I'm not trying to get fired on my day.
Oh, okay. I'm with you.
But currently the glove does fit for the Dallas Cowboys, sir.
I'm Marcellus. Not with you today.
We're not doing it. Marcellus.
What?
Stop making a defense for this, bro.
Why? Because like, you're mad because you have
to do some
work.
I'm not even mad.
Go.
I grew up in Dallas. I grew up 15 minutes from the stadium.
I can tell.
Old Stadium, Valley Ranch, New Stadium, Arlington. I worked in Frisco at the Star One Cowboys Way, all that. Like, I rock with the Cowboys. I have an affinity for them.
Oh,
but
do
I'm
you?
Not blind.
So,
like, your defense is truly that the Cowboys have only lost to one bad team.
True.
Marcellus, the Cowboys are making these other teams great teams. Let me talk about it, bro. The Cleveland Browns, if the Cowboys would have beat them, we wouldn't have said the Browns were great. The Browns hung 49 on the Cowboys.
That's every team.
Beat the Cowboys in a star. So we said, you know what? The Browns must be legit.
That's every
team. The New York Giants, they had their season high against the Dallas Cowboys. The Arizona Cardinals, They had their season high in points against the Dallas Cowboys, and they played an overtime game on Sunday night. The Washington football team, they had their second season high against the Dallas Cowboys.
Yes, sir.
Where else do I go? The Atlanta Falcons, they had their season high against the Dallas Cowboys.
Your point.
The Cowboys are making these teams appear even greater. So you're talking out both sides of your mouth. Yes.
I am being direct. I just got you on the ropes.
No, I don't. I'm not even against the ropes. I don't even have to bob and weave this. It's a terrible argument. You're talking on both sides of your mouth.
I'm ready. I got more.
You were saying that the Cowboys have lost to great teams, but in the same breath, the Cowboys are making the teams great. It doesn't.
I didn't say that. You said the other part. First of all, I said. Boy, you think you slick up here?
I tried.
Dog, I've been 29 before. I know how to play the game.
Look at you.
All I said is there are seven teams with a worse record, so how can you consider them the worst? And second of all, they beat a team in their own division. How can you consider them the worst? But I don't want to be a literalist up here. Let's have some fun with this because you keep talking about your affinity for the Dallas Cowboys. You're from Dallas.
Yes,
and you know what's funny? I've learned about you guys from Dallas playing out there and then just working with you, that you guys suffer from something I call a cowboyotic syndrome. And you and Michael Irvin are suffering from the same disease right now.
Prescribe me a medication,
okay?
Please. I don't want to suffer any longer.
Let me help you out.
Please.
You guys are marketing geniuses, just like your owner and Jerry Jones. This is all a marketing strategy you're doing. Let me give you this example that kind of illustrates what you're doing with your cowboyotic syndrome. There's only two audiences to you, and Money Mayweather realized this, and I'm going to get to that in a second. There's only two audiences out there, the ones that love you and the ones that love to hate you. That's how you make the most out of life. That's how you get the biggest buzz, and that's how you suffer from cowboyotic syndrome. Now, Michael Irvin has learned from a Floyd Mayweather, and it sounds like you're learning from a Michael Irvin. What did Floyd Mayweather do to illustrate this? Money Mayweather had a marketing model and a switch that went from, I'm Pretty Boy Floyd. Do you remember Pretty Boy Floyd? Oh, the gold chains, and I'm gonna wear it, and y'all just gonna love me for my greatness. And then he realized, I need to be polarizing. That's not gonna work. I gotta create another audience and make them always constantly fight. That's why we talk cowboys every single day. The audience is always having infighting and then fighting the world because they're the greatest. So that's what you and Michael Irvin are doing right now. Y'all usually come up here and talk with love. Cowboys are this, cowboys are that. That much talent. Oh, it's the Cowboys' year. And then you realize, they sorry this year. Not the sorriest, but they sorry enough to talk to those who love to hate the Cowboys. And now you and Michael Irvin are going to go to the extreme just to sell a point because you just loving the conversation about the Cowboys. I can see through that thin veil, big dog. You over here trying to act like you are really off on the Cowboys when really your root interest from your home for your affinity is for you to always say, go Cowboys. You're telling on yourself, big dog.
I like that. I like that.
Because it's true.
There was a whole lot of filler and no substance, but I like that. It's like eating a cake. All you came with was calories and do nothing for my health. Sal, here's the issue, bro.
I'm listening.
The Cowboys are not the worst team in the league.
What?
I said that. I said it. I said they weren't.
You said yes first.
Block. No.
You said yes, and you said my real answer.
I said they're sorry enough to be considered one. I'm not going to defend them as not being the worst, though.
Okay.
Here is why.
Okay.
You got the third worst coach in the league.
Mm.
You're starting a quarterback with like
third
three
worst
last
coach.
Names. Third worst coach. Adam Gase is worse. The Falcons,
Super Bowl
whatever
champion,
they got going.
A Super Bowl champion is the third worst. Go ahead. Keep going. I'm listening.
Third worst coaching staff. Better, Marcellus.
Okay.
Better. You happy now?
Yeah.
Gosh, you be getting on my nerves. They got the third worst coaching staff in the
league. Listen.
They got a quarterback, Ben DiNucci, who's about to start this upcoming game. They got a team with no heart. I can't defend a coaching staff that's terrible, a team with no heart, and a team without a quarterback. So, the Cowboys have talent. If it was a conversation of who has the most talent or who's the least talented, I would never utter the Cowboy. The Cowboys got talent galore. Everywhere you look, talent. But here's the thing, Marcellus, let's talk track and field.
Let's do it.
You can have all the fast twitch muscles in the world, which would make you an elite sprinter. You can have calves, you can have quads, you can have hamstrings, everything can be fired.
High calves, high booty.
You can have everything,
Sam. Oh, you fast. Bow-legged too?
Bow-legged too.
Oh, you can run. Don't waste somebody bow-legged with high calves.
Hey, straight up.
Big booty.
I swear.
They're going to smoke you.
Uh-huh. But you can have all that, Sal, but if you got a torn Achilles, you're not going anywhere.
Hey,
the Cowboys have all the talent at receiver.
What's a torn Achilles?
They got talent at running back, but they got a torn Achilles at quarterback.
Okay, I get
it. The Cowboys got talent at defense. You got Leighton Vander Esch. You got Jalen Smith. You got DeMarcus Lawrence. You got a second-round pick at cornerback, Trayvon Diggs. But you got a torn Achilles, a defensive coordinator. Mm. So the Cowboys can't go anywhere.
Oh, really?
So are the Cowboys the worst team in the NFL?
Oh, really?
Again, I'm not going to say that they are, but what I'm going to say is they have a torn Achilles at quarterback, keeping them from being able to run to their maximum ability on offense right now. They got a torn Achilles at defensive coordinator, keeping them from being able to sprint to their maximum ability on defense.
Look, stop it. This is not a torn Achilles. This is a sprained ankle. High ankle sprain. No more, right? You're locked down, Dak. You're out for a while. It's going to take time to recover from this. But in this high ankle sprain, let's just be real about it. They have two wins. The division-leading Philadelphia Eagles also have how many wins,
Acho? Two wins.
How many wins?
Two wins.
The same? What? The same amount of wins? And who has the... Now it's moving every week because the team's winning and losing. Who has the sixth easiest remaining schedule and two games against that division-leading team, Philadelphia? The Dallas Cowboys. So when you keep telling me about how they can't go forward, actually they can. Recover from injury, which is Dak Prescott out, and maybe Andy Dalton out as well. But recover from injury and then lend yourself to all the talent that you have around you. They're not the worst team by far. They're not the worst team in their division. And if you don't get yourself right, you may look up and they'll be leading this same division. Ooh. Coming up, Tom Brady is a three-time MVP. We'll tell you if number four will happen for the GOAT in Tampa Bay. Next, speak for yourself.